In this section, I'll be briefly covering the knife tool. I've covered most of the tools of Affinity in depth on my channel, so you can go and check that out for a more in-depth review of it. So, where is this tool? Well, it's on the left-hand side in the tools panel. The shortcut for it is K. This is the icon. I've redesigned the icon so it's more identifiable. So let's go ahead and click on the knife tool. And you can see the icon has changed of my cursor. It's now a knife. And you can also see in the context toolbar, we have some options. But for now, I'm just going to use it as default. So on this ellipse here that was selected, I'm just going to click and I'm going to drag down like this. And when I let go, what has happened? If we look in the layers panel, it's now two layers. And what I can do, just while still in the knife tool, I can click once on that section and it's highlighted it. And I can either press delete, and that's just gotten rid of that section, or I can press Command Z to go back. And I can either head to the move tool, which is V, and I can click and move it across. Maybe I want to create something like that. Or I can press A, the node tool, and start playing around with this side a little bit more. But as you can probably see, it's quite a jagged edge, not very smooth. So what I'm going to do is press Command Z to go back to its original state. Now I'm going to use K on the keyboard. I'm going to use that shortcut now. And we're going to head up to the context toolbar. So the first one, it says Options Straight Line. I'll click it. Now I'm going to click and drag. See, this is just dragging out a straight line, so I could just lop the top off. And of course, you can include the Shift key to keep it in a straight line. So I can let go, and now it's just lop the top off like an egg, and there it is. So press Command Z again. The next option is Auto Close. So if I click on Auto Close, and I will click off of straight line again, basically I can do this. I could go inside of it, draw a line, and then you see that little red dot? As soon as I go close to it, it's going to connect together and complete the shape. And now it's cut a little hole out. So if I press V, I can just remove that. Okay, I'll press Command Z again and go back to the knife tool. I'll click off of that. And the next one is Stabilizer. Stabilizer is available in the pen and pencil tool, which you'll see, and the paintbrush tool, the vector brush tool. So I'm going to select that. And the first option under Stabilizer is Rope Mode, and the next one is Window Mode. Let's just quickly use Rope Mode, and I'll just show you. So Rope Mode, I'm dragging along, and you can see there's this rope that's helping me make it a little bit smoother. Okay, great. But let me press Command Z to go back. You see this length? If I just click on that and drag it up, I can increase the length of that rope. So again, I can click and see the rope is a little bit longer, and it's making it a lot smoother. And there we go. That's really nice and smooth, isn't it? So that was rope mode. I'll press back a few times and we'll try the last one, which is window mode. And when I click on window mode, it says window 25. So let's just try it. Click and drag it. And if you can see, when I speed up, it kind of follows me like a rubber band. That's what that's doing, the window. So if I just press Command Z one more time and we increase that window, I will click and drag from over here. And you see it's kind of a lot more controllable. And there we go. So I kind of call that rubber band mode. So that is the knife tool. If you want to see more, go see the full tutorial.